Ja, ruf einfach, lass klingeln. You hear that? Telephone. Mother. Stopped. Okay. We can go on. Welcome to Caseback Watches. My name is Tim, and this is part two of the episode How to Pronounce German Watch Brands. I started in the first part with 10 brands, and sillily I thought this is enough, but it wasn't enough. So I've read the comments, and I read your suggestions, and so here are another 10 watch brands from Germany and how to pronounce them. Damasco, yes, it's not a German word, it's an artificial word, so I think the Americans would say Damasco, maybe Damasco, and a German guy would say Damasco, but the same rhythm, da-dub-dub, da-dub-dub, Damasco, Damasco, Damasco. D. Dornblüt und Sohn. Dornblüt means a flower with thorns on it. And Sohn means, of course, and sons. Same thing. D. Dornblüt und Sohn. It's not Glashütte original. As I explained in the first video, Glashütte is not a brand. It's a name of a city with a very long tradition in watchmaking. So several German brands, they use Glashütte in their names, like this one. And it's Glashütte, Glashütte, Original. And Original is German, yes, but it's learned from the French. Original, Original. I hear the same rhythm in this. Original. Glashütte, Original. Google Steve McQueen and Hanhart, and then you're gonna find a gray watch chronograph from made by Hanhart. And that's the correct pronunciation, Hanhart. Word like a scrambled egg, and it's called Henschel. 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 It's not the most beautiful word in the German language, and it's called, yeah, Henschel. Yeah, this sounds very German, even for German ears, and it's called Junkers. It's not Junkers, nothing to do with junk, I guess. In fact, a Junker was a member of the aristocracy. Oh, it's so hard mixed German with English. Junker is a member of the aristocracy. Yes, aristocracy, without, but he's not a knight, so they called him Junker. Yes, and the correct pronunciation is Junkers. Leica, very famous for producing cameras, high-end cameras. And somebody in the comment asked me what I think about their watches. And very sorry, I wasn't aware that they produce watches. And I never owned a Leica, so I can't say you nothing there. But I can explain the pronunciation, and it's Leica. Leica. It's like the dog in space. The Russians, they sent a dog in space few decades ago, and this was Leica, Leica. Mark and Sons. Yeah, a little bit strange. It's a German company, but the pronunciation is English. You can say because they use the son instead of the Sohn. And the founder of the company is Marco Heimrich. And Marco, it's an Italian name, but it's very popular in Germany. Why? I don't know. And of course then this Mark is an abbreviation of Marco, but I think he wants us to say it in English, Mark and Sons. Okay. Nautische Instrumente Mühle Glashütte. This is maybe, this is even for Germans sometimes a little bit hard. Nautische Instrumente is nautical instruments. Nautische Instrumente Mühle is a mill. And Glashütte is, of course, as I explained, the town. So we have Nautische Instrumente Mühle Glashütte. Nautische Instrumente Mühle Glashütte. How can you be successful with such a name? Steinhardt. Very simple. It's just Steinhardt. And it means rock hard. Or hard like rock. And I think they want us to think that their watches are hard as rock. Tutima, yes, German brand. I didn't know that, and I don't know how to spell it, frankly. I think Tutima, yes, an American would say Tutima, Tutima, Tutima. No, I think the whole globe would say Tutima, and maybe this is the trade secret for Tutima. You can't spell it. Tutima, nothing more. So now we have the pronunciation of 20 German watch brands. Frankly, I wasn't aware that there are so much watch brands from Germany. I'm more of the Swiss guy. By the way, Oris Pointer Date, vintage Oris Pointer Date from the 90s on leather. And now let me thank you very much for your attention, and until next time.